took me down to the river so I could drown, drown, drown.
Alright, last level of Undead. It's gonna be fun on the bun. You have 30 minutes here to survive the onslaught of 3 human bases. So it's like that level in the human campaign where you have to survive against 2 Undead bases, except a lot harder. Okay, one entrance, the entrance to the main base, build 5 extra ziggurats, and the other 2 entrances, just build 2 more. So you have 3 on that and 6 on... 3 on each one of those, and 6 on the other one.
My sight is yours.
Then get the 2 acolytes, or the 3 spare acolytes you're given, to build a gold mine. And they give you loads of shades in this mission, so sacrifice nearly all of them. The only 2 you really want to keep, you only really want to keep one by each entrance to the right-hand blue base, and fuck's sake. And the left-hand blue base. I swear, I really hope they use more colours when it comes to... Oh yeah, well, in Night Over, you get to play as the blues, don't you? So I don't have to keep saying blue blah. Getting tongue-tied. Anyway, the first attack will come about a minute into it. And you don't really need to be that prepared. The right blue base like to send things like... Knights, footmen, riflemen, later on they'll start using things like mortar teams and sorcerers and priests. Sorceresses and priests, should I say. The left-hand blue base like to use tactics. Well, they only use dwarves, to be honest. They only use gyrocopters, steam engines, and riflemen. And the top grey base, there isn't actually an entrance anywhere near. The top grey base likes to use things like Griffin Riders and Knights, mostly. Make sure you've upgraded your Halls of the Dead to a Black Citadel as soon as you can. And then start upgrading your Ziggurat. And if you need more extra gold, sell everything you don't want to keep that Kel'Thuzad left. Upgrading your attack and defense will help a lot. There's also an optional quest on this mission where you're given 12 goblin landmines. All you have to do is to complete the optional quest is to break open the box. For the first 20 minutes of the mission, the only units you really want to build are crypt fiends. I wouldn't really suggest building out of the crypt as it won't be that useful. So just keep building crypt fiends. Make sure to upgrade web. That's an essential, really. Because the amount of griffins you'll be attacked with, and gyrocopters, you need to take out gyrocopters before they reach your ziggurats. It's about the 10-minute mark where you'll want to start building more stuff other than just crypt fiends. You'll want to start building things like necromancers and meat wagons if you want, because skeletons are actually very good for defense. If your main part of being, you know, if you're Arthas and your main crypt fiends are being attacked at another part of your base. You'll also be given, during the course of the mission, a bunch of fellhounds. You'll find fellhounds are absolutely brilliant because their mana burn is excellent. Because later on you'll be attacked by a lot more priests, a lot more sorceresses, and heroes. And you'll find the mana burn is excellent for stopping any archmages using blizzard, summoning water elementals, things like that. Now, in previous playthroughs, I've actually gone through this level without using any of the goblin landmines. Recently, I found out you can actually destroy buildings with them. So what I've done here is I'm going to use 9 of the 12 landmines and set them up around the Light Blue's castle. If you take out Light Blue's production abilities, then you'll stop them from being any danger to you at all. And I think the Light Blue base is a lot easier to destroy like this than the Dark Blue base. Mostly because they use a lot of range units, which means they're not going to have any knights getting in your way, or not many anyway. They're also easier to get to, and their production facilities are a lot closer together. You can take out two of the workshops at the top end of the base. It means that there's only one left, and that can be easily destroyed with meat wagons. Because with all those landmines you'll be leaving around, you can easily take out their entire army in the base, their hero, and all their peasants. So you take out the castle, take out the peasants, and take out those two workshops with just Arthas and his landmines, and then use your meat wagons, which I told you you should have built by now, to destroy that one last workshop just by the entrance to their base. Okay, so now that I'm at the 10-minute mark, I'm going to start producing a lot more units. Earlier on I built a boneyard, which was completed before the 20-minute mark. Now I'm going to start building things like frostworms, abominations, and just more big hitters. Also get some banshees in, because their curse attack is very useful. If they miss, 33% of the time, then it's a real blessing. 10-minute mark, you'll also be given some infernos. Any unit given to you by the Burning Legion won't count towards your food count, which is excellent, because you can still build many, many more things. But I would suggest staying out of high upkeep at least until the 10-minute mark. That way I'll have plenty of money to do with as you please. Later on in this guide, I'll give you a list of all the enemy waves that are sent towards you, assuming you don't take out any of their bases. And if anyone thinks about trying blocking the enemy in with walls of shades, don't even bother, because the shade wall doesn't work in the latest update. In fact, it hasn't worked for many. And once again, once you get down to the minute and a half mark, the enemies will send you everything from their bases. Everything from the blues, everything from the greys, and the stragglers left from the light blues if you left them alive. There's not much to really say here. Final words of wisdom, just make sure you try and keep your health up with death coils. Try and keep... also, there's a fountain of health and mana by just below Kel'Thuzad. And at about 45 seconds, you'll want to retreat everyone. Just to have everyone surround Kel'Thuzad. That way, it'll be a lot harder for them to actually get to him. You've completed the Undead campaign. This mission was pretty hard, but it's still not quite hard enough to get the coveted 10 out of 10 on my old difficulty scale.
Tremble, mortals, and despair. Doom has come to this world.
Doom? Aw, I'm really more of a GoldenEye kind of guy. Being a last mission, you can find a few things around the map to make your life a bit easier. Just in the center of the map is an archmage with a ring of protection plus 5. There's also a tome of strength plus 2 in that hut there. The other thing you might find or might find useful is in the bottom right hand corner of the map there are a couple of knolls, and there's a scroll of healing in that thing there. You know what, I wouldn't even really bother trying to even think about getting those, because I mean, if you got some frostworms and some spare time, by all means kill them for the gold, but going up there and collecting the item with Arthas requires a zeppelin, and that would just take far too long and just waste far too many valuable resources. The last thing you might find useful in this level is a little toy box here. It's easy enough to run in with Arthas and kill everyone. You can find a Scepter of Mastery, which you can use to take control of up to 3 other units. It's a cool item. You can run in there no problem, grab it and then run out. The best time to use it probably right at the end of the mission when you're being swarmed with knights. And just use it on the 3 most powerful units you can. I suggest either knights or griffins.